Dear listeners, tonight I beckon you to step into a realm of enchantment and mystery, where the streets of 19th century New Orleans are alive with the scent of jasmine and the whispers of ancient secrets. Relax, close your eyes, and let the story whisk you away to a city where shadows dance and destiny can be altered by the will of a determined heart. Join us as we delve into the tale of Seraphina, a powerful fortune teller, and her quest to protect her beloved city from impending disaster. Prepare to be captivated as we journey together through a world of mysticism, courage, and timeless magic. The Voodoo Queen of New Orleans. Journey through shadows. In the heart of 19th century New Orleans, the air was thick with the scent of jasmine and mystery. The cobblestone streets echoed with the distant sounds of horse-drawn carriages and lively jazz music, creating a backdrop of both charm and enigma. The vibrant city, with its rich blend of cultures and traditions, seemed to pulse with an energy all its own. An energy that Seraphina, a renowned fortune teller, had long learned to tap into. Seraphina's small parlor was a sanctuary of mysticism within this bustling city. Nestled in a quiet alley, the building was covered in ivy, its wooden shutters painted a deep, welcoming green. The parlor's interior was dimly lit by flickering candles, their soft light casting dancing shadows on the walls, adorned with mystical symbols and tapestries. The air inside was a blend of exotic incense and the sweet fragrance of jasmine flowers, carefully placed in vases around the room to enhance the ambience. Seraphina herself was a figure of intrigue. Draped in flowing, colorful robes, her fingers were adorned with rings bearing various stones, each believed to hold its unique power. Her dark hair, streaked with strands of silver, fell in loose waves around her face, framing eyes that seemed to hold the wisdom of the ages. These eyes now stared intently at her worn deck of tarot cards, shuffling them with practiced ease. The cards had been her constant companions, their edges frayed from years of use, each one imbued with the essence of countless readings. Her clients came from all walks of life, seeking guidance on matters of love, fortune, and destiny. They trusted her insights, believing in her ability to see beyond the veil of the present into the unknown depths of the future. Tonight, however, Seraphina felt a strange unease. The air seemed charged with a peculiar tension, a sense of foreboding that prickled at the edges of her awareness. As the candles flickered and the shadows danced, Seraphina laid out the cards for the night's reading. Her movements were deliberate, each card placed with a sense of ritualistic precision. The first card she revealed was the Tower. A shiver ran down her spine as she gazed at the image of a tall, crumbling tower struck by lightning, figures tumbling from its heights. The tower symbolized sudden upheaval, destruction, and a dramatic change that was often catastrophic. It was a card that rarely appeared, and when it did, it never heralded good news. With a sense of growing dread, Seraphina turned over the next card. Death. Contrary to its fearsome image, The death card did not always signify literal death, but rather the end of a significant phase or the beginning of a profound transformation. Yet, in conjunction with the tower, it suggested a more ominous interpretation. The skeletal figure on the card seemed to stare back at her, a silent reminder of the inevitability of change and the potential for great loss. The final card she revealed was the Ten of Swords. The depiction of a figure lying face down, 10 swords plunged into their back, was a stark image of betrayal, pain, and a devastating end. Seraphina's hands trembled slightly as she placed the card down, completing the triad that painted a bleak picture of the future. Together, these cards foretold a series of catastrophic events that would soon befall New Orleans, a city she loved dearly. Seraphina knew she had to act. The cards had given her a warning, a glimpse into a potential future filled with turmoil and tragedy. She could not, in good conscience, ignore this dire prediction. It was up to her to decipher the hidden meanings within the cards and use her mystical abilities to alter the course of destiny. The task ahead was daunting, but Seraphina was not one to shy away from a challenge. She understood that the power of the tarot was not just in foreseeing the future, but also in empowering one to change it. As the night deepened, Seraphina sat in her parlor, surrounded by the comforting glow of the candles and the heady scent of jasmine. Her mind raced with possibilities and plans. She would need to delve deeper into the mysteries of the cards, seek out additional sources of wisdom, and perhaps even enlist the help of others who shared her understanding of the mystical arts. The fate of New Orleans hung in the balance, and Seraphina was determined to do everything in her power to protect her beloved city from the impending catastrophe foretold by the ominous reading. Determined to prevent the impending disaster, Seraphina revisited the cards, searching for any clue she might have missed. She spread the cards out once more on her small oak table, dimly lit by the flickering candlelight. The Hierophant and the Moon cards caught her eye immediately, their intricate designs almost seeming to shimmer in the soft light. The Hierophant, a card representing spiritual guidance and authority, suggested that someone wise and powerful held the key to the mystery she was trying to unravel. The Moon, with its connotations of illusion, intuition, and secrets, hinted at mysteries buried deep within the city's past. Together, these cards whispered of a powerful figure who could help her, someone intimately connected with the hidden truths of the city. Her quest for answers led her to a dusty old library in the French Quarter, a place that seemed forgotten by time. The library was tucked away between two tall, narrow buildings, its entrance obscured by overgrown ivy and a weathered wooden sign that creaked in the wind. The cobblestone path leading to the door was uneven and cracked, showing signs of neglect. As she pushed open the heavy wooden door, a musty smell enveloped her, a mix of old paper, leather, and a hint of mildew. Inside, the library was a labyrinth of towering bookshelves, each filled to the brim with volumes of all shapes and sizes. The air was thick with dust, and motes danced in the shafts of light that managed to penetrate the grime-covered windows. The silence was almost tangible, broken only by the occasional creak of the floorboards under her feet. It was as if time had stood still in this place, preserving it as a sanctuary of forgotten knowledge. Seraphina wandered through the aisles, her fingers brushing over the spines of the books as she searched for anything that might provide a clue. The books seemed to whisper to her, their secrets waiting to be uncovered. She was drawn to a section tucked away in the far corner, its shelves filled with ancient tomes and manuscripts. The books here were older, their covers faded, and pages yellowed with age. Many were written in languages she couldn't understand, but she was undeterred. It was here, in this neglected corner, that she found the ancient manuscript. Its cover was worn, and the title was barely legible, but it radiated a sense of importance. Carefully, she pulled it from the shelf and carried it to a nearby table. She opened it with reverence, the fragile pages crackling under her touch. The manuscript detailed a ritual, one that could alter destiny itself. The ritual was complex, involving various rare ingredients and precise incantations. As she read, a sense of urgency gripped her. This was it. This was the clue she had been searching for. Her eyes widened as she came across a particularly troubling requirement. The tears of a voodoo queen. This rare ingredient was essential for the ritual's success, and without it, all her efforts would be in vain. She leaned back in her chair, the weight of this revelation settling heavily on her shoulders. She knew of only one person who could provide such a rare and powerful ingredient, the legendary voodoo priestess, Marie Laveau. Seraphina had heard countless stories about Marie Laveau, tales woven into the very fabric of the city's history. Marie was said to possess incredible powers and a deep knowledge of the occult, making her both revered and feared. Convincing her to help would not be easy, but Seraphina had no other choice. The stakes were too high, and time was running out. Gathering her things, Seraphina left the library, the manuscript clutched tightly in her hands. The sun was setting as she stepped out into the street, casting long shadows across the cobblestones. The French Quarter was alive with activity, the sounds of music and laughter filling the air. But Seraphina barely noticed, her mind consumed with thoughts of how she might find and persuade the elusive priestess to aid her. She made her way back to her small apartment, a modest space filled with books, candles, and various trinkets she had collected over the years. The apartment was her sanctuary, a place where she could think and plan her next move. She spread the manuscript out on her desk, poring over the details once more. She knew she needed to prepare carefully before seeking out Marie Laveau. The priestess was known for her discerning nature and would not offer her help lightly. It was not an easy voyage for Seraphina through the winding streets of New Orleans. The city appeared to twist and turn in ways that made navigating difficult, with its narrow streets and busy marketplaces. With deliberate gaits, she conveyed her resolve to track down the fabled voodoo queen, Marie Laveau. The noises of children playing, sellers yelling out their wares, and the faint tones of jazz music drifting through the air filled the streets with life. However, Seraphina was preoccupied with her task. Marie Laveau's home was known to many, yet shrouded in mystery. It was said to be a place of great power, where the walls whispered secrets and the very air vibrated with spiritual energy. As Seraphina approached the house, she felt a mixture of apprehension and determination. The house stood at the end of a narrow street, its facade both welcoming and intimidating. Vines crawled up its walls, and the scent of herbs and incense hung in the air, creating an atmosphere that was both enchanting and ominous. Seraphina knocked on the heavy wooden door, her heart pounding in her chest. Moments later, the door creaked open, revealing Marie Laveau herself. The voodoo queen was a formidable woman, her presence commanding and her eyes piercing. She wore a flowing gown adorned with symbols of her craft, and her hair was wrapped in a colorful turban that added to her regal appearance. There was an aura of power about her that made Seraphina feel both awe and respect. "Marie Laveau," Seraphina began, her voice steady despite her nerves. "I am Seraphina, a fortune teller. I come seeking your help. I have seen visions of a dire fate awaiting our city, and I believe you are the only one who can help prevent it." Marie Laveau's eyes narrowed slightly as she listened, her expression unreadable. She gestured for Seraphina to enter, and they moved into a room filled with the rich scents of burning candles and exotic herbs. The walls were lined with shelves holding jars of ingredients, talismans, and ancient books. A large altar stood at the center, adorned with offerings and symbols of the voodoo faith. "Tell me more," Marie said, her voice calm but commanding. Seraphina explained her vision and the dire events looming over the city. She spoke of the tarot reading, the ominous cards, and the ancient manuscript detailing the ritual that could alter destiny. Marie listened intently, her gaze never leaving Seraphina's face. After a long silence, Marie finally spoke. "What you ask is not impossible, but it comes at a great cost. Altering destiny is a dangerous endeavor, and the spirits do not grant such favors lightly. Are you prepared to pay the price?" Seraphina nodded, her resolve unwavering. "I am," she said firmly. "Whatever the cost, I am willing to pay it to save our city." Marie studied her for a moment longer, then nodded. "Very well. The ritual you speak of requires a rare ingredient, the tears of a voodoo queen. I will provide them, but know that this act will bind us both to the outcome. Success or failure, we will bear the consequences together." With that, Marie turned to her altar and began to prepare the ritual. She moved with a grace and precision born of years of practice, selecting various ingredients and chanting softly under her breath. Seraphina watched, feeling a mixture of awe and apprehension. She knew that what they were about to do was no small feat, and the weight of their task pressed heavily on her shoulders. Marie produced a small vial from her robes and held it to her eyes. With a deep breath, she allowed a single tear to fall into the vial. She then handed it to Seraphina, who accepted it with reverence. The tear shimmered with an otherworldly light, a tangible manifestation of the Voodoo Queen's power. Together, they began the incantation, their voices melding with the night. The words of the ancient spell flowed from their lips, a harmonious blend of power and intent. The air around them seemed to shimmer and pulse with energy, and Seraphina could feel the presence of ancient spirits gathering to witness their endeavor. As the ritual progressed, Seraphina felt a deep connection to the spiritual realm, as if the boundaries between the physical and the mystical were dissolving. She could sense the spirits listening, weighing their pleas and the sincerity of their intentions. The energy in the room grew intense, almost overwhelming, but Seraphina and Marie remained focused, their voices unwavering. Finally, as they reached the climax of the incantation, a surge of power filled the room. The candles flickered wildly, and the air crackled with electricity. Seraphina felt a wave of energy wash over her, and for a moment, she was lost in a whirlwind of visions and sensations. When the ritual ended, a profound silence settled over the room. Marie looked at Seraphina, her eyes filled with both relief and warning. "It is done," she said softly. "We have set the wheels of fate in motion. Now, we must wait and see if the spirits will grant our request." Seraphina nodded, feeling a sense of both accomplishment and uncertainty. They had done all they could, and now it was up to the forces beyond their control to determine the outcome. As she left Marie Laveau's home and stepped back into the labyrinthine streets of New Orleans, she felt a renewed sense of purpose. Whatever the future held, she knew she had done everything in her power to protect her beloved city. The days that followed the ritual were filled with tension and uncertainty for Seraphina. She was keenly aware of the weight of what she and Marie Laveau had attempted. The air in New Orleans seemed charged with an almost palpable sense of anticipation. Every sound, every flicker of light, every whisper of the wind carried with it the possibility of change. Seraphina watched and waited, her nerves taut as she looked for any signs that the ritual had worked. At first, it seemed as if nothing had changed. The tarot cards continued to hint at turmoil and danger. Seraphina laid them out each morning, hoping for a different outcome. But the images of the tower, death, and Ten of Swords still dominated the spreads. An uneasy quiet settled over New Orleans, as if the city itself was holding its breath, waiting for something to happen. Despite the ominous readings, Seraphina refused to lose hope. She went about her daily life, offering readings to clients and keeping a vigilant eye on the world around her. Gradually, she began to notice subtle shifts. The first sign came in the form of a storm, initially predicted to hit New Orleans with devastating force. The storm inexplicably changed course at the last moment, veering away from the city. Seraphina breathed a sigh of relief, though she knew it was just one event in a series that needed to change. The next sign was even more miraculous. A fire broke out in a crowded part of the French Quarter, threatening to spread and cause significant damage. As the flames roared and panic ensued, something extraordinary happened. The fire, which should have raged out of control, was suddenly extinguished, as if an unseen hand had doused the flames. Witnesses reported seeing a strange, inexplicable mist that enveloped the fire and smothered it completely. Seraphina couldn't help but feel a swell of hope. Perhaps the ritual was working, after all. But the true test came in the form of a violent uprising. Tensions had been simmering in the city for weeks, and it seemed inevitable that they would boil over into conflict. One evening, as Seraphina walked through the streets, she sensed a disturbance. Crowds were gathering. Voices were raised in anger, and the air was thick with the potential for violence. Seraphina hurried to the scene, her heart pounding in her chest. As she arrived, she saw a confrontation on the verge of erupting into chaos. The atmosphere was electric with rage and fear. Just as the first blows were about to be struck, a profound stillness fell over the crowd. It was as if time itself had paused. Seraphina could feel a presence, a guiding force that seemed to calm the people and diffuse the tension. The anger dissipated, replaced by a sense of confusion and relief. The crowd slowly dispersed, leaving Seraphina standing there, her heart swelling with emotion. She had managed to avert disaster, and in that moment, she realized the true power of what she and Marie Laveau had accomplished. Destiny, it seemed, was not set in stone. It could be altered, influenced by those who had the will and the wisdom to do so. Seraphina's heart swelled with relief and pride. She had proven to herself and to the spirits that guided her that she could make a difference. As she returned to her parlor, Seraphina gazed at her tarot deck with a newfound sense of purpose. Each card, once a harbinger of doom, now seemed to hold the potential for change and hope. She knew her role as a guardian of New Orleans had only just begun. The city was filled with secrets and dangers, but also with beauty and resilience. Seraphina was determined to continue her work, to protect and guide her beloved city through whatever challenges lay ahead. The cards had given her a warning, but they had also given her a gift. The knowledge that she had the power to shape the future. With this realization, Seraphina felt a deep sense of responsibility. She would continue to use her abilities to foresee and to alter, to protect and to heal. The spirits had entrusted her with a great task, and she was ready to face it. In the days that followed, Seraphina noticed more signs of positive change. The city seemed to breathe easier, its people moving with a sense of renewed hope. While the challenges were far from over, there was a sense that the worst had been averted. Seraphina's readings began to show more balance, the cards reflecting not just the potential for disaster, but also for recovery and growth. She continued to work closely with Marie Laveau, the two women forming a bond of mutual respect and shared purpose. Together, they watched over New Orleans, ready to act whenever the need arose. Seraphina's parlor became a place of refuge and guidance, a sanctuary where the past, present, and future intertwined. As the city moved forward, Seraphina knew that her journey was ongoing. The role of a guardian was never easy, but it was a path she embraced with all her heart. New Orleans was her home, and she would do everything in her power to protect it. With the lessons of the past and the hope of the future, Seraphina stood ready to face whatever destiny had in store. And that, my listeners, was the Voodoo Queen of New Orleans. If you enjoyed tonight's tale from the heart of New Orleans, don't forget to give a like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell so you never miss a mystical story. What would you do if you were in Seraphina's place? Let us know in the comments below. Until next time, sleep well and stay curious.